I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you,
good morning. It is Tuesday, October the 18th. Pastor Larry here. And wanted to give a video deal with this morning. The verse today is really about salvation. And I don't typically do a lot of verses on salvation because the app doesn't always give them. But this is a great verse, not just about salvation, but about assurance, about people who maybe struggle. Sometimes, I'll be honest, I don't wake up and I feel like I'm saved or feel like I'm a child of God. But thankfully, it's not about a feeling. It's about trusting in what God's word says, because God's word is final on the matter, not how I feel, not what I think. It's what I know God's word to say to be true. And the verse says this: verily, verily, I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him that sent me hath everlasting life, and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. You see, as I live this life, as I walk, as I try and do my best to live for Christ or go on in my life, there are times where I fail to do so. I fail to live for Christ. And I'll be honest, there have been times where that's gone on for a while, where I don't really try and live for him. I don't really try and serve him. And I really just make life about me. And it gets easier to do that as the days go by. And as the days go by, before long, I really don't feel his presence. I really don't feel close to him. I really don't feel like, I'm what I'm supposed to be. And so then, because I'm not what I'm supposed to be, then I start to figure maybe he's not what he's supposed to be. And the devil can use that feeling, that emotion. Emotions are great. God's given us emotions, but emotions aren't how we dictate our salvation. That's not what dictates whether I'm saved or not. It's about what God's word says. And so while emotions may be a good thing, they can also be a bad thing, and our flesh and the devil can use them against us. And so as it is that I'm away from God at that point in time, I start to think about those things. And because I'm failing to be who I'm supposed to be, then I feel like God is failing to be who he's supposed to be. But the problem is, those are just feelings, and that's not truth. Because the truth is, if I've heard God's word, and I've believed that God sent Jesus Christ to die on the cross for my sins, to give me everlasting life. Because the Bible says, and a couple chapters before this, in John chapter 3, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That's God's word on the matter. So my feelings have no relevance. My emotions have no relevance. Now, the great thing is, when I repent, when I get myself back to a place where I feel close to him, then my feelings then quit betraying me, and they start to exalt Christ in my life. They start to make me feel great about who he is and close to him. And the emotions then are wonderful. And it's not condemnation, but it's exaltation. And so I want to encourage you today. One, if you're not born again, hey, go to faithbaptist.us, schedule a meeting, call us, reach out to me through email, whatever. Let's get together, have a cup of coffee, a Coke, something. And let's talk about Jesus, and I'll show you how you could know Jesus. And if you do know Jesus, and there's ever been a point in time in your life where you've put your faith and trust in who he is and what he's done, but maybe you've just got away from all that, you've got away from who he is, and you started to think of him more as pertaining to who you are than who his word says he is, then, man, just trust his word. Get back in his word and watch how he'll change your emotions, change your feelings to something that would more, instead of betray him, that would cause you to cling to him. Hey, if you want me to pray for you, then please, again, reach out to our website. Hit faithbaptist.us and hit that request prayer button and fill that out, and I will pray for you. And I'll stay in touch to see how things are moving and if there's anything else I can pray for. Just know that I want to serve in that aspect, okay? Have a great day. God bless, and hopefully we'll see you again soon.